So I'll just give a short historical perspective to this instrument before I come down to the details of how it is constructed and what we play on it. You can see this is a very it's a very old temple, and on which you can see an apsara holding a veena. It's a veena was basically a family of instruments. It's a generic term, and there are various types of veenas. And one of the veenas is this veena, which we call as the Rudra veena. There is Saraswati veena, there is Godi veena, there is Kindari veena, there is also other types of veenas are there. But this is one of the most prominent and one of the most important types of veenas, which we also find on some of the temple architecture. Description of some of the veenas in some of the ancient texts. Narada Sangeet Makand, he mentioned 19 types of veenas. Then there is Palkuliki Somnath, he also mentioned 17 types of veenas. Adi Shankaracharya in his Sundarlehri refers to the deity of Saraswati playing veena, which is known as Vipanchi veena, we call it. Then the veena that is played by Narad Muni is called Mahati, and the musician Tambur used to play veena known as Karavati. So this is with reference to some of the ancient texts where the veena is mentioned. Now this is again an interesting veena. It's a very longish, but a very longish fretboard, you can say. It's a Dan Vyoti Kores, and on which you can find that there are sarikars. These frets are known as sarikars. There is this round toma on the top. There's no toma, we can't see in here. So it's probably one of the veenas in which there is only one toma which is placed, and you can see the ear is placed closer to the toma. I'll come to that later on. This is another veena. This is Gunath Chandra. You can see the position in which this veena has been played, in almost in the Sukhasana posture. And the veena is strung on the shoulder. And you can see one toma here. The other toma probably it's not here, you can't see it anymore. So there is reference to veena in various ancient texts, also in Ramanas, in Tathagata Ramanas, in Aranyak, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Sharangadev, of course. Then of course various forms of deities and apsaras. Now let me come to the construction features of it. What is it made of, and what are the various parts of this veena? Basically, this is a tubular body. This is the tubular body. You can see the tubular body. And there is a toma. There are two tomas, three tomas in the case of Kindari veena. This is made for God. God is a family
of pumpkin.
Not pumpkin, we call it Loki. It's a round donkey.
Kaddu.
No, not kaddu.
Yeah, kaddu.
It's like a kaddu. I'll come to that. Well, I used to have a workshop on the top of my house in Delhi, and I used to make these darts. You can see some of the instruments. I used to make these. Veenas. I have also made 4 or 5 veenas with my own hands using these instruments. And this is a bamboo dan. It means that this can be of bamboo. It can also be of any other wood, such as teak. We use a lot of teak and also rosewood. But this is a bamboo dan. So this is a bamboo the raw bamboo which is used. What we do is that we cut it and slice it, cure it, take out the extra material from inside, and then join it together after curing it. Now, coming back to this is Tomba, again the water god, and on it she has a lot of decoration done. These are wood pieces which are pasted on the god, and then you do a lot of carving over it. And these are attached to the dam. You can see these are the attachments. And finally, one of the most important part of it is known as the swan bridge. This is basically what we call as the Hansa. Saraswati's Hansa. And you can see it's a very interesting bird. It's not the swan that we see. It's basically a very short-necked bird. It's probably what we call as a mythical bird. Hans was more like a mythical bird than a real bird. It's a short-necked and a round body. And what we do is that it's a one-piece construction. We carve out the swan, the Hans. Then we hollow it, and then we put what we call as these bridge pieces made up of either deer horn or it could be bones of camel or that similar ivory material. Ivory is not used anymore, but it used to be. Well, this is the final construction configuration. The other side, there are two strings. Known as the Chikari strings, sounds like this. Chikari strings on the plain side. Alright, now let's come to the posture. How to play it? There are various postures. You can play it sitting in Veenasana. That is one of your, one of your knees is on the ground and the other is at the top. Or you can sit in the Vajrasana. This is Asadarikasa. You can also play it, especially the bigger ones, what we call as the Gagavinas, by placing them on the thigh, in the Sukhasana or in the Padmasana posture. And of course, the smaller ones, you can play it even while standing. It is one of the ancient paintings, dating back to the 16th century. Where you can see that a woman is playing this same Veena in standing posture. Well, this is from the Venu temple. This is the woman in sitting position. This is a different type of Veena because it's got what we call as a soundboard. It's a roundish soundboard. It's more like a sitar. The Indian classical music basically is of two types. One, as Charandev calls, a Desi and a Margi. Margi music is music that pleases the gods, and Desi pleases the common folks. So what we do is that the Ras can be played in either in Desi way or in the Margi way. What we do on Rudra Veena is that we play a Ras. What is a Ras basically? Ras is nothing but a set of notes which are used to evoke certain emotions in human being using certain grammatical structure. So you need to know a little bit of the grammar of the Ra, which means that you need to know something about what are the notes that the Ra is composed of, then what is the jati or what is the structure, and then how do you Pakar means what are the features of this structure and how do you play? Well, this is some of the visualizations of some of the Ras. These Ras are supposed to evoke also emotions inside human beings. This is a Todi Ragini, which is supposed to attract the deer. It says that Shaldev talks about Nag, which comes out from the navel basically. It says that it comes from the navel and it comes to the heart and then to the throat. And it is differentiated into 22 grades known as Shrutis. And see, he says 22 Shruti successively higher in which are produced by the fourth of brain acting upon them. Similarly, 22 Shrutis are discerned in the throat as well as the cerebrum. Then he says that Swara is something which comes after the Shrutis. And then the second Swaras.
Yeah. Hare 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 Hare
part we have the chant, but have other ways of recitation of the Ved parts. So you use similar way you scramble the words of the mantras in order to come at a very the level of concentration that you are able to focus on the mantra using the raag elaboration. So this is one of the techniques that we use in yoga. Then you also have jod and jhala, of course. Jhala is a faster portion of it. Compositions in pa ra va a ti na tha shi va pa ra va ti na